Okay, let's set the plan view to story number one. Zooming into this side, and let's start to draw our first column cross section. By default, this column is aligned in the X direction. We need to rotate it just 90 degrees. Okay, now let's choose the second column cross section. We need to add a column here and here. At the middle here. Okay, this is all for the columns. Now we need to add the walls, but before that, let me show you one thing in AutoCAD. I have created this grid system in order to create the walls and in order to mesh all the system based on this division. Therefore, I will create this grid system now inside ETABS. From add modify, let's copy this existing grid system and modifying this. I will stop the recording screen a little bit just to modify this. Okay, that's all for the new grid system. Let me hide G1. Now from this option here, a quick draw walls, let's draw our walls. I always draw from left to right and from down to up, okay? Just this is something related to local axis. Actually, it's really interesting to show local axis while we are drawing our sections, okay? Now let's choose this one, draw walls, fixed lengths. I will copy this or replicate this in linear X direction by a 1.5 plus 1.5. Also, I have here a small wall because the opening here at a certain elevation, then we need to start our wall from the base, okay? Now we need to do the same for here, for this side. Okay, now we need lastly to draw this core here. And here. Okay. Now we can draw our slab element also in a quick way using this option. Let's select the slab 250 and just drag the mouse from the left to the right. We can now select those elements and delete them because here we have opening and similarly to this side. Also, let's disable the local axis view from here. Okay. Okay, let's zoom in here to this location. We need to delete these slab elements as here at the middle we have window opening. We need to do the same for this side also. Also, we need to draw the coupling beam. Therefore, I will select first all the walls and I will show selected objects only. Now let's check this option here and zoom in to the location of coupling beam, choosing the coupling beam section from here and just draw it. Okay, show all objects. Also, to make things more easier, let's display the colors based on the section property. Also, we can change the graphics by changing the text height, for example, to 4. This will increase the text of the dimensions. Also, we can display different colors of dimensions. For example, let's select the black. Now it's more obvious to us the dimensions of this floor plan, okay? Now let's select again all the walls. Show selected objects only. I will replicate those. Let's put the 3D view just to story number 2. And okay. Now we need to create the openings for the window and for the doors. Let's go to the AutoCAD drawing. I have prepared this section of the core number 2. We need to use these dimensions. For example, the height of the door is 2.25. Also, the window starts at the same elevation and it has a height of 1.2 meter. Okay. For this purpose, I will first use the grid system G1. Let me hide G2. Also, I will go to the G1 grid system. I will add a reference plan. The first one is at an elevation of 2.25 meter and the second is on 3.45. Okay, and okay. Okay, if we set the elevation view at grid B, we can see that there is two lines added here. I will select first all the segments of core number 2 and core number 3, and I will divide those shell based on intersection with visible grids. Now if we go again to the same elevation, which is at the grid B, we can see that we have divided these walls. We need to select those two pieces and delete them. Okay, and this way we have created the window opening. Similarly, we need to go to elevation C. Let's put elevation C here. We need to delete this one. This one. Actually, we need also to do some modification here at this level. I will delete this one and this one. Now we need to add another reference plan for coupling beam. We need to add it here. This is 5.1 meter. Okay. Modify 5.1 meter. Now we can see that there is a reference plan added at this elevation. Okay, let's put the plan view to story number 2, selecting those wall segments. If we put the 3D view, let's check if all wall segments in this story have been selected. Okay, now we need to create another division based on the intersection with visible grids. Now let's go again to elevation C. Let's delete this portion of the door and this portion. Of course, we need to delete this one also, and this one. Show all object. And now let's define the pier labels before replicating the story number 1 to the upper stories. I will define 4 pier labels because I have 4 core walls. And okay, now let's select the walls from the select option and right click on the screen, show selected objects only. Selecting the first core wall, going to the assign shell pier label P1. This is P2, P3, and P4. Okay, show all objects. Now, if we set the plan view to story number 2, we can find that we have just here the walls. We need to replicate the columns and the slab elements. I will select the first story. Then I will deselect the walls, okay? And if we go to the edit, replicate it to story number 2. Now we can see that everything is copied to this level. We can again select all of this story and replicate it to story number 8. Okay, now we need to assign effect support to the base of these walls and columns from the assign joint restraint option, clicking this here and apply. Also, we'll need to define diaphragm, ridge diaphragm, and ETABS by default do it for us, okay? Let's define now the load patterns. We need to define also superimpose dead load as a super dead, the self weight is 0, okay, and okay. Now, if we click here the mass source, this is actually the effective seismic weight that gonna be used in the computation of seismic forces. Therefore, I will specify these loads from here. I will just include all the dead loads, okay? I will not include any portion of the live load. We need to add here a shell element to this gap, okay? For that, I will select the walls first. Show selected objects only. I will view the local axis of shell elements just to make sure that our drawing is correct. I will use this option here and I will use wall 200. I will draw this wall segment counterclockwise, okay? And as we can see, the new local axis is just same as the rest of the segments, okay? Now we need to do just the same here. Okay, now we need to assign pier label for those new wall segments. This is P2 and that one is P3. Let's turn off the local axis of shell elements. 3D view, show all objects and save.